Hello, I'm Ethan with Splunk Education. In this video, we look to the past by learning a few different methods of accessing search history in Splunk. You may already be familiar with the search history menu available on the homepage of the Search and Reporting app. This is the first method that allows us to quickly navigate and find previously run searches. Selecting the arrow on the left will expand to show the entire search string. We can even add them instantly to the search bar to run again. While this is a great time saver, it doesn't give us much information about these searches. The next method, utilizing the history command, allows a Splunk user to search for previously run searches in the current application. It is a generating command and should be the first command in your search. By default, the search history will be returned in the form of a table, great for aggregate viewing of field values for event underscore count, execution time, and many more. The history command can also return the search history listed as events. By adding the optional argument events is equal to T for true. This view is a great option for convenient highlighting or field inspection within each event. Another great way to view previously run or even currently running searches is by selecting Activity, then Jobs. The Jobs menu has a lot of the same information we just saw in the results of the History command, in addition to new values like when the search will expire. There are filtering options at the top to view jobs from different applications, owners, and statuses. We can also interact with our searches from this menu by selecting the Job drop-down menu under the Actions column. From here, we have the options to edit job settings, extend the job expiration date, inspect or delete the job. Also, under the Actions column is the option to pause, stop, share, or export the job. Alternatively, we can manage jobs in bulk by selecting the checkbox at the beginning of the row for each job and choosing Edit Selected. Thanks for joining us to learn more about how to access search history in Splunk. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on our Splunk How To YouTube channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.